Let's look at how to name aldehydes and ketones. And let's start with an aldehyde. And just to refresh your memory about how to recognize an aldehyde, right? There's a carbonyl present, right? A carbon double bonded to an oxygen. And there's an alkyl group on one side and a hydrogen on the other side. And so if we wanted to name this extremely simple molecule over here on the left, right? We know there are a total of four carbons and it's an alkane. So we would call this butane, right? So if we look at a four-carbon aldehyde right over here on the right, so when you number an aldehyde, you want to make your carbonyl carbon number one, so 1, 2, 3, and 4. And so we have a four-carbon aldehyde, and what we're going to do is drop the E, right, and add AL for aldehyde. So this would be butanal, right? So a four-carbon aldehyde is butanal with an AL ending like that. Let's go ahead and look at some more examples. So once again, we're going to number to give our carbonyl carbon the lowest number possible. And the aldehyde is going to take priority over things like double bonds and alkyl groups and halogens. And so let's go ahead and look at this one on the top left here. And so we want to number to give our carbonyl carbon the lowest number possible. So 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. And so we have a 5-carbon aldehyde, right? Well, a 5-carbon alkane would be pentane. And so a 5-carbon aldehyde would be pentanal. So let's go ahead and write pentanal here. So pentanal. And then we also have a substituent, right? At carbon 4, we have a bromine. So we have to go ahead and put that in. So a 4-bromopentanal would be the IUPAC name for this molecule. Let's do this one over here on the right. And so once again, we're going to number giving our carbonyl carbon the lowest number possible. So 1, 2, and 3. So we have a 3-carbon aldehyde, but this one has a double bond in it. So a 3-carbon aldehyde would be called propanal, but since we have a double bond present, we're gonna call it propenal. All right, so we have propenal here. So let's go ahead and write that. So propenal. And then the double bond starts at carbon 2 right here, so we could write 2-propenal. We also have a phenyl group coming off of carbon 3, so we could write 3-phenyl, so 3-phenyl in here. And if you want to specify the stereochemistry of the double bond, right, you think about a hydrogen being here and a hydrogen being here, and so when you think about this double bond here, the hydrogens are on opposite sides, so you could say that's they're trans. Right, or you could use the EZ system, and your highest priority groups are on opposite sides here, so this would be E. So go ahead and write E. So E3-phenyl-2-propenal is one way to name this molecule. It's kind of the old way of doing it. If you want to do it the newer way, right, you would write E, and then you still have a phenyl group here, so 3-phenyl. And for the new way, you would write prop, and then put the 2 in here. So prop-2-ene, and then al. So once again, the 2 specifies where the double bond is, and you still have your al ending. And so this is the more modern way of doing it. And so these are both IUPAC names for cinnamaldehyde, right? So this molecule here is actually cinnamaldehyde, which is the molecule that gives cinnamon its smell, right? So this is a fantastic smell, and you can steam distill cinnamon bark and isolate this molecule, which is a great undergraduate organic chemistry lab to do. And so that's cinnamaldehyde. All right, so another great smelling aldehyde over here on the left, right, is benzaldehyde. So here we have benzaldehyde, which is such a common name that it's been incorporated into IUPAC nomenclature. And benzaldehyde smells like almonds, right? So this is another fantastic smell. So labs with benzaldehyde are a lot of fun too. So if you see benzaldehyde, right, you can use that in your IUPAC name. And so if we look over here on the right, we can see that benzaldehyde can form the base for the name for this molecule. And so let's go ahead and write that over here. So we have benzaldehyde. Right? And then we're going to number to give this carbon on our ring number 1. Right? So we have two choices. We can go around the ring clockwise or counterclockwise. And we know we want to give the lowest number possible to our substituents. And so that would be by going around clockwise. So let's do that. So 2, 3, and then 4. So we have two substituents. Right? We have a methoxy substituent here at carbon 3. And we have a hydroxy substituent here at carbon 4. And so we need to put those into alphabetical order. So H comes before M. And so we're going to start with the hydroxy. So let's, hopefully we'll have enough room here. So 4 hydroxy, right? And then we have 3-methoxy. Benzaldehyde is the IUPAC name for vanillin, right? So vanillin, of course, is where we get our vanilla flavor from. So a fantastic vanilla smell. So these are white crystals which have an amazing vanilla scent to them. So also a lot of fun to do labs with. All right, so a lot of aldehydes have nice smells to them. Let's look at 2 more aldehydes. All right, so let's look at the one on the left here, right? So it's not benzaldehyde. We don't have a benzene ring here anymore. We have a cyclohexane. So this one is going to be called cyclohexane carbaldehyde. So cyclohexane carbaldehyde is the IUPAC name for this. So carbaldehyde. All right, let's look at this molecule over here on the right. So this is 2 aldehydes in the same molecule, right? So let's look at this. So it'll be 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5 total carbons. And so it's 2 aldehydes, so it's going to be diol, and it's 5 carbons total, so it's going to be pentane. So we could write pentane diol here. And if you wanted to put where the numbers are, right, so it'd be 1, 5. So you could put that in there. So 1,5 pentane diol for 2 aldehydes. All right, let's look at ketone nomenclature next. And so just to remind you of the general structure of ketones, right, so once again, you have a carbonyl, a carbon double bonded to an oxygen. And this time you have 2 alkyl groups, right? So you have two alkyl groups here, and they could be the same or they could be different, right? So I could write R prime here. And either one would still be a ketone. So once again, we looked at butane earlier, right? So our 4-carbon alkane butane. And what about if we had a 4-carbon ketone? All right, so this right here is a 4-carbon ketone. So it wouldn't be butane, it's an O-N-E ending, it's an one, so it'd be butanone, right? So we're gonna drop the E here, right, and add O-N-E, so butanone. It gives us the IUPAC name for this molecule. So there's an old way of naming ketones, which is to think about the 2 alkyl groups, right? And so let's go ahead and look at that. There's a methyl group on this side, so let's go ahead and write methyl right here. And then on this side, there's an ethyl group, right? 2 carbons, so methyl, ethyl, and then ketone gives you the structure for this molecule too. So methyl ethyl ketone is kind of the old way of doing it. And normally you would put the E before the M, just thinking about the alphabet. But for this one, you know, it doesn't really matter. Everyone knows what methyl ethyl ketone is, also abbreviated MEK. So naming the alkyl groups is an old way of naming ketones, which you will sometimes still see. All right, so let's do another one here. Let's look at a longer ketone. So we want to number to give the ketone, the carbonyl carbon, the lowest number possible. And so we start from the left, right? So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. So we have a 6-carbon ketone, right? So it's going to be hexanone. So let's go ahead and write that. So this would be hexanone. And we need to identify where the ketone is this time. Right, so it's on carbon 3 here. So for longer molecules, it's important to specify where it is. So it would be 3-hexanone is one of the ways to name this molecule. Again, this is kind of the old way of doing it. So the newer way would be to write, for this one, hexan-3-one. And if you wanted to use the alkyl way of naming this molecule, you could say this is an ethyl. Right, so you're going to write ethyl here. So ethyl, and then on this side, a 3-carbon alkyl group is propyl, so ethyl propyl ketone is just another way to name it. So several names for the same molecule. All right, ketones take priority over things like double bonds and alkyl groups and halogens once again. So if you look at this molecule, you want a number to give your ketone the lowest number possible and not your double bond. So we're going to start from the left again. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. So we have a 6-carbon ketone. So that'd be hexanone, but we have a double bond present, so it's going to be hexenone. Right? So we have hexenone as thinking about our base name here. And once again, two ways to think about naming it, right? So I could do hexenone, so hexene, and then we have our ketone at carbon 2, so hexene 2-one. So the 2 goes with the one, right, to tell you where the ketone is. And then the double bond starts at carbon 4 right here, so 4-hexene 2-one. And if you want to specify the stereochemistry of the double bond, so once again, you have the hydrogens on opposite sides, so that would be trans or E. Right, so you could just write E here. So E4-hexene-2-one is one way to name this. Again, kind of the old way of doing it. If you wanted to name it another way, right, you could write E, right, and then you could write hex, and then 4-ene. So once again, the 4 is going with the ene part, telling you where the double bond is, and then you have the 2-one as well. So whichever way you prefer. All right, so let's look at two more examples here for nomenclature of ketones. So what if you have a ketone in a cyclic molecule here? So if I think about what I have, right, it would be cyclohexane, but I have a ketone in my ring, so it'd be cyclohexanone. So let's go ahead and write that. So cyclohexanone, indicating we have a ketone present. And so we know that ketones take priority over alkyl groups, so we're going to give this carbon a number 1 on our ring. And we're going to choose to go around clockwise because that gives the lowest number to our alkyl group. So we go 2 and 3. And so we have a methyl group at carbon 3. So it'd be 3-methyl cyclohexanone as the IUPAC name. All right, and then finally, what happens if you have two ketones in the same molecule here? So we want to give lowest number possible, so we start numbering from the left side. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. All right, so we have two ketones. That's going to be a dione. So one way to name it would be to say, well, it would be hexane, and then we have two ketones, right? So dione, so hexane dione. The ketones are at 2 and 4, right? The carbonyl carbons are at 2 and 4, so 2,4-hexanedione is one way to do it. And, of course, you could also do it the more modern way. You could just write hexane, right? And then after hexane, so hexane just tells you of 6 carbons. You could write 2,4-dione. All right, so that's it for nomenclature of aldehydes and ketones.